Hello, and welcome back to Movie Chapter. Today I am going to show you 2015 drama sci-fi short film called Getting Fat in a Healthy Way. Spoilers ahead. Watch out and take care. The movie starts as a fat man and his lean wife are outdoors with their child, Constantine, for a dry picnic. While they are swinging Constantine on their hands happily, the wife notices a towel flying to the sky. Suddenly, the gravity stops working at once. Everything except for the fat man starts floating up to the sky. The wife and the boy also start floating up. The fat man grabs his son, and the son's hand is chained with his mother's in the air. However, the mother puts on a goodbye face and relinquishes her son's hand in the air. Devastated, the fat man is in utter disbelief as his wife flies high in the sky. As he pulls his son and hugs him tightly, he wakes up from his dream with a heavy breath. This is a true incident that Constantine's father faced 20 years ago after the Earth's gravity and the moon's shape were affected by a devastating American aircraft accident. Due to the accident, the world entered a dystopia where anything weighing less than 120 kilograms flies up in space. Next, we get a view of the disturbing shape of the moon above a set of apartments. Constantine and his father are having their food in the kitchen. The table is attached to the wall through a bracket, and a gravity meter is working inside the house, making sure everything is in check. The bookshelf is also seen caged with a fence. A man on television talks about the day being the marking of the 20th anniversary of the unfortunate mission of the American shuttle New Land. He informs that the anniversary of the accident falls on the full moon and alerts that there are high chances of damage to the naked eye. As the TV man asks all the viewers to maintain a minute of silence for the memory of those who perished in the accident, a large sound is heard in the room, which shocks the father-son duo. Soon, the plates and the food start flying to the ceiling. Constantine struggles to hold his hand on the table while his body floats in the air. Despite his best efforts, he loses his grip and rises to the ceiling in an instant. Constantine's father curses the fuses and goes to the gravity machine. He rotates a knob and alerts Constantine that he is going to switch on the machine. As Constantine closes his eyes and prepares for the fall, the machine starts. The father covers his head with his hands as the pieces of stuff flown to the ceiling start falling. Constantine cries in pain as he thuds to the ground. The father then puts a photo of his wife back on the wall. He asks if Constantine is all right, while Constantine checks his aching body. Later, Constantine's father checks his weight in the weighing machine and discovers it to be a little more than 120 kilograms. He gets worried that if his weight drops to less than 120 kilograms, he will become helpless like his son. Then, he carries a spherical metal ball marking 20 kilograms in his bag. He informs Constantine that the coffee is on the table as he flies to work. As Constantine is always behind four walls for his lesser weight, he takes a binocular and watches through the window to the streets. He finds a man in a military uniform holding a floating bag with his hand. He then sees his father talking to two fat women who are apparently walking their dogs on floating leashes. At the other apartment, he notices a woman throwing a musical instrument at a man on the ground, but it floats back to her again. One of the women on the street starts gossiping about Constantine's father torturing Constantine for not letting him out. She suggests that he can come out with a rope tied to him. As they talk, their floating dogs bark louder. Tired of being at home and envious of the fact that he can't go out, Constantine tries his best to live a normal life. He plays a cassette of the sea with the sounds of waves. He then opens up an umbrella and covers the sofa with it. He focuses the light on one of the sofas. He undresses his layers of clothes and the pillow from his body, which he uses to shield his body against the gravity fluctuations. He then puts on the sunglasses, lotion and starts sunbathing. Later, Constantine gets up and goes to the window after hearing the honking of a vehicle. A cute and chubby lady walks out of the vehicle and looks up. As Constantine gazes at her through the binoculars, she unties her hair which flies up, and she waves her hand at him. Constantine immediately feels shy as he hasn't had any interaction with women since birth. He puts on his clothes along with his pillow and writes down hello on a chart. He then stands up to show it to her, but backs out at the final moment. After his father arrives home from work, Constantine serves him food that he cooked. His father notices the apron and tells him that it is for women. Constantine replies that it is unisexual. The father exclaims it belonged to his mother and suggests he put it back in its place. Constantine obliges and then returns to his table. The father again checks his weight in the machine again before heading out. He sighs with frustration as it gets nearer to 120 kilograms. Constantine peeps through the door hole and confirms his father has gone. Then, he collects the adult magazines and selects one of them. Constantine covers himself with the blankets to dive into the excitement. He imagines the girl from the van playing swing. Suddenly, Constantine gets disturbed as the magazine falls to the ground with a sound. He picks it up and finds the page titled Getting Fat in a Healthy Way. He looks at the advertisement of the burger, which states that with good food, one can easily gain 120 kilogram weight. After the advertisement convinces him, Constantine orders a huge number of burgers and starts having them. After eating, he checks his weight and becomes happy at finding it to be more than 60 kilograms. Meanwhile, he hears the vehicle honking and quickly writes his name on the chart paper. As the girl of his dreams walks down the vehicle, he shows the chart through the window glass. The girl looks at it and waves her hand to Constantine. After his magical encounter, Constantine starts finishing his remaining burgers. Despite having difficulty in swallowing them, he does not give up. He pushes the burgers down his stomach and finally finishes them off. Soon, he feels uncomfortable. The father receives a phone call stating that Constantine has suffered from food poisoning. He hurries home quickly. As he arrives, he sees Constantine sick in his bed, while the medical personnel prepare to leave. Later at the kitchen, Constantine finds a note written by his father over the fridge which states not to forget his promise, while his father is flying to work. Constantine checks his weight and gets disgusted at finding it to be around 50 kilograms. He puts some pillows inside his dress and sits to write something in the chart, dedicating it to the girl. Down, the girl looks at Constantine's room, but doesn't find him there. Frustrated by his life, Constantine tries his best to go out. He binds himself with a fridge and pushes it hard to make it to the door. As he is about to leave, his father enters the house back from the office. He pushes the fridge back to the room with Constantine still over it. The father then transports all the machines and heavy equipment from the room as a precaution. Constantine gets annoyed upon not being able to express his love to the girl. The father comes into his room and finds everything torn and thrown to the ground. He goes back to his room and sits at his table to work on a pair of shoes. After working, he falls asleep in the chair. He dreams of his son leaving the grasp of his hand and flying up the sky. His eyes open with shock on seeing this. When he wakes, he finds his wife's photos and other small stuff stuck in the ceiling due to the faulty fuse of the gravity machine. However, he notices that the shoes did not fly up. He throws them from a height and notices them falling downwards. The father then switches on the gravity machine, and everything stuck to the ceiling falls to his head. When Constantine comes to the kitchen the next day, the father brings the pair of shoes and puts them on the table. Constantine comments that they are ladies' shoes. The father replies that the shoes are unisexual. Constantine slowly puts on the shoes and carries a bag of metallic weights, while his father looks on proudly. He then turns the gravity machine off. But this time Constantine doesn't float, which makes both of them happy. Constantine then moves to the ground outside the apartment with the shoes and bags on. His father watches him from the window. He heads towards the apartment ahead. The girl from the van is watching him from the balcony of her room. He reaches below her apartment and looks at her up. All of a sudden, he shuts off the power of the shoes, despite his father screaming not to do so. Constantine then throws his bag away and takes out the pillow from his body too. He closes his eyes and keeps on rising upward. However, he feels someone's hand grasping his shoulder and not letting him go any higher. Constantine smiles as he sees the girl he loves in front of her smiling back at him. After watching the events unfold, Constantine's father winks at the photo of his wife. At the end of the movie, the radio floats up in the sky. The man on the radio welcomes their surprise guest, an American astronaut Dusan Pradic, and asks him to say a few words. The astronaut, who was also a part of the fatal accident, starts with an apology. He then announces that the world will probably never recover from the dystopia they put into. Subscribe my channel for more videos like this, turn on the notification, and leave a like to help the channel grow. Thanks for watching.